The HP Embedded Web Server, or EWS, is an application that runs on HP printers that allows you to configure your device from your computer using a standard web browser. For this video, we are focusing on the EWS that comes with HP Enterprise and Managed Category Printers, MFPs, and scanners running HP FutureSmart 4 firmware. To access the HP EWS, type the printer's IP address into your preferred web browser. The printer automatically redirects to an HTTPS secure connection to encrypt the communication between your computer and printer. The SSL certificate included with your printer is a self-signed certificate which are not trusted by most web browsers, but does not affect the security of the communication. We can easily bypass this restriction in each browser, or we can install a CA certificate to remove the error. For this printer, the administrator password has not been set. You can tell because you can see most of the configuration options. If the password was set, you would only see the information menu and would need to enter the password to access configuration options. The EWS has some standard information available on every page. Let's review each item in turn. The device information is contained at the top of the page, including the model number and IP address. There is a menu bar that goes across the page to take you to different information and configuration categories. The menu along the left side of the page provides access to different configuration options inside the selected category. The search bar helps you quickly find the configuration options you are looking for. The message center is a small hover pop-up that shows you the current warning or error messages on your printer. The home button quickly takes you back to the first page of the EWS, the information menus, and device status dashboard. The sign-in, sign-out button that allows us to gain access to all the features of the HP EWS. The HP EWS is consistent across HP printers, MFPs, and scanners with the same level of firmware. It differs according to the features available for that model. For example, a single function device does not have copy, digital sending, or FAQs tabs that are available on MFPs and scanners. On most of these pages, you'll find the help link in the top right corner of the page. This link quickly launches context-sensitive online documentation to help you find the right answer when you need it. We typically recommend that you connect to the HP EWS using a desktop browser for the best ease of use. If you need to access the EWS from a mobile device, the pages are responsive and the navigation collapses and becomes a drop-down menu. We need to sign in to see all the options available in the EWS. If you have set an administrator password, simply enter the password on the sign-in screen, then click the sign-in button. Since we have not set an administrator password, we can simply click the sign-in button on the sign-in page. The Information tab provides an overview of your HP printer. The Device Status tab is a quick dashboard that shows you your supplies and media status. The Configuration page allows you to discover the current printer firmware version, product configuration, and an overview of your current security settings. The Event Log page shows the date and time of the error, the event code, a description of the issue, and a link to online troubleshooting resources. The Control Panel Snapshot page shows the current screen on the printer, while the Remote Control Panel, which is only available if you're signed in, allows you to control the printer as if you were standing in front of the device. The Print page on the Information tab will allow you to send print-ready files and PDFs directly to the printer without the need of a printer driver. The General tab provides access to various settings to control the general functionality of the printer. The Home Screen Customization page allows you to change the button order and even set a custom wallpaper for your printer. The Alerts page provides an easy way to get notified if the printer state meets one of your specified conditions. The Date, Time Settings page permits you to adjust your printer's date and time, and even allows you to configure a network time server. The Backup and Restore page allows you to save the printer configuration to a network folder and then restore that configuration to the same printer or another printer of the same model. The Copy, Print tab allows you to change the default copy and print settings. The Print from USB Drive settings allows you to turn off printing from the USB drive to meet customer security requirements. The default Print option settings control how pages are printed when no application or print driver settings are present. These options are used when printing from USB or via the print page. The Print Quality page offers configuration of the default print quality settings, management of the image registration, the ability to auto-sense behavior, and customize paper types. The Copy Settings page modifies the default options for copy jobs and allows you to manage quick sets. The Manage Trays page provides a quick way to modify paper types and view the status of each paper tray. The Scan Digital Send tab provides configuration for scan destinations and contact configurations. The email setup can be configured to work with Gmail, Office 365, and other cloud-based or on-premise email servers. The Scan to Network folder page provides a way to configure quick sets for saving files to specific network folders. Scan to SharePoint, which may not be available on all models, connects you directly to either an on-premise or Office 365 SharePoint server. The Scan to USB page can be used to turn off the USB port for scanning or to create Scan to USB quick sets. The Contacts page allows you to import and export your contacts as well as configure LDAP lookup to get contacts from your LDAP server. There is a setup wizard that makes the email to scan to network folder configuration quick and easy. Remember, the Help button guides you to additional resources to answer many of your scan-related setup questions. The FAQs tab provides the option to set up analog FAQs using an internal modem, if one is installed, LAN FAQs, or even Internet FAQs functionality. It also allows you to quickly manage your FAQs speed dials, control FAQs archiving settings, and view the FAQs activity log. The Supplies tab is a quick way to manage the supplies warning thresholds. The Troubleshooting tab is used to view or print reports and tests, perform calibration and cleaning to help maintain your print quality, reset the printer to factory settings if it is not functioning properly, and upgrade printer firmware to keep your device up to date with the latest security features. The Security tab provides overall management of the main security features of the HP printer. The General Security page is for setting passwords, including the administrator password and the remote configuration password. The Account Policy page controls the password complexity requirements. The complexity requirements are based on the Microsoft Active Directory default password complexity requirements. The Access Control page provides authentication methods and locks out access to certain features unless you have authenticated. The Protect Stored Data page controls hard drive security such as encryption and how to erase and manage jobs stored on the device. The HP Web Services tab is for configuration of HP Connected Services and HP Jet Advantage Solutions Enablement. The Networking tab provides the ability to control the communication functionality of the printer. The Wireless Station page, if available, allows you to connect to an existing wireless network. The TCP/IP page controls the network connection information, such as domain membership, DNS settings, IPv4, and IPv6 settings, as well as controlling some of the advanced security features such as HP Connection Inspector. The Network Settings page contains configuration options for SNMP settings, including enabling or disabling SNMP V1 and V2 read-write settings, and creating the SNMP V3 passphrase. The Other Settings page shows several additional communication protocols that are active and allows you to enable or disable each one to further secure your printer. The Authorization page allows you to specify a list of IP addresses that have authorization to access the HP EWS and change the configuration settings. The HP EWS is the best way to manage the capabilities of your HP printer. This overview just scratched the surface on what HP EWS can do. Learn more about configuring your HP printer by viewing more of our HP EWS support videos.